Hey everyone, what's up? My name is Zelly Jornak. I am a third year business administration major concentrating in marketing from Millbrae, California in the Bay Area.
Hello, what's up? My name is Danae Aquino and I'm a fourth year computer science major minoring in psychology here at Cal Poly. My pronouns are she, her, hers, and I'm from Seattle, Washington.
Hi y'all, my name is Bree Zedar. I'm a third year mechanical engineering major here at Cal Poly. And I'm from Cleveland, Ohio.
Hi, everybody. My name is Grace Lauer. I am a third-year architecture major with a minor in sustainable environments. I'm originally from Edina, Minnesota, and my pronouns are she, her, hers.
I'm a part of PolyReps, which are Cal Poly's official university ambassadors, and one of our roles is to give campus tours. And while we are so upset that we can't have you in person on campus today, we'll be leading you in a virtual tour of campus
with the hopes that you'll be able to make an informed decision at the end of the day and maybe see yourself on this campus in the future.
All right, so a little bit about the overall academics at Cal Poly before we delve deep into each of our colleges. Cal Poly follows its philosophy of learn by doing, which essentially means that students at Cal Poly are able to get hands-on experience throughout the different classes, which is one of the reasons why we have you declare your major right away, is because you get to start in your major your very first quarter at Cal Poly. So you're not getting those latter 2 years of experience, or you're getting 4 years of experience in your major, which allows you to follow the upside-down curriculum that we have, which is where you're able to funnel down exactly from that general broad major into a specific focus or area of concentration by having so much time. And this learn by doing that we foster at Cal Poly really emphasizes the day one readiness, that when students graduate, they are ready day one to go into their job and start working and require a lot less time to train because they've already done a lot of the things that employers would usually train them in their classes.
I'm so proud to be giving you a virtual tour of the College of Architecture and Environmental Design. So let's get started. We have five amazing majors, but three have really great nationally renowned programs. Architecture is one of the top public programs in the nation. Landscape architecture is the top program in the nation. And construction management has 100% job placement pre-graduation. So before our students even walk across the stage, they have jobs, and jobs with really cool companies that sponsor a lot of our lab spaces here at Cal Poly. All architecture and architectural engineering freshmen have to participate in a class and project called Design Village. We have to build a structure to sleep in the entire weekend in Poly Canyon Village. We had about a couple weeks to design, a couple weeks to fabricate, and then all of the groups in all of the freshman classes hiked their structures out to Poly Canyon Village. It kind of looks like Burning Man, not gonna lie. There are structures that are super metallic, some light up, everyone's in costumes, we're blasting music, cars are honking their horns at us as we walk up to the canyon. It's super fun. And then you install them and sleep in them the entire weekend.
Whoa, crazy seeing you here, Mr. Einstein. We're gonna talk about the College of Science and Math. Standing in front of me is Baker. 6.5 giraffes tall. Just a fun little PolyReps fact for you. When this building was getting renovated and built, the dean was like, what do Cal Poly students truly want in a building and in their experience at Cal Poly? And Cal Poly students were like, we'd love to have this lecture lab style where what we learn in class, that lecture, can be literally directly applied to the lab right then and there. And so that is what most of the classrooms within the College of Science and Math in Baker are, is that lecture lab. So the cool part about that is Cal Poly students actually have the opportunity to apply everything they're learning from lecture right then and there to lab. One of the cool learn by doing examples that is kind of showcase this through is the cadaver lab. People are dying to get into it. Crazy. But so this cadaver lab itself, one of my friends, Alec, he's actually a biomedical engineer here at Cal Poly, and he took the cadaver lab his freshman year, which is crazy because most students don't really have the opportunity to do that until they are a graduate student. But he took this class wanting to go into sports medicine, and he said this class really solidified that for him. So a really cool way for Cal Poly undergraduate students to get like hands-on learn by doing experience. We are just around 21,000 undergraduate students, and only 1,000 throughout all of Cal Poly are graduate students. And so Cal Poly students really have the opportunity to do this undergraduate research while of course they're just studying to get their undergraduate degree. degree. I've had a couple friends that will stay for the summer and actually work with their professors in order to do a lot of research projects and stuff like that. So it really is that hands-on opportunity straight out the gate. Another cool experience and learn by doing opportunity that we have here is we recently purchased a pier out in Avila. And so now marine sciences students can actually come out to the pier themselves, check out the waters and understand the environment that a lot of these marine life animals are living in, identify different marine life animals. So it's really cool to see Cal Poly students live by this learn by doing motto, but also get outdoors doing it.
I am now standing outside of the Orfila College of Business, which is my home college. There's three majors within the College of Business, which include business administration, industrial technology and packaging, and economics. Business administration is actually the largest major here at Cal Poly. So as a business major, you are required to declare a concentration after your second year. And within your first 2 years, you're taking introduction courses to each of those concentrations that include accounting, finance, marketing, information systems, and more. Which means that while you're going to have a concentration, you're going to have a well-rounded experience and background in those other areas of the business world as well. Great success stories here at Cal Poly include Jamba Juice, Clif Bar, Urban Dictionary, Visco, all either student projects or Cal Poly alumni that have started because of the entrepreneurship that is fostered here. Cal Poly is actually the number one packaging program in the nation because it's the only program that has its industrial technology and packaging program within a business college.
What's up, y'all? Right now, I am standing in the center of our engineering quad, which as a mechanical engineer is one of my favorite places on campus. It is where a lot of your engineering classes would take place here at Cal Poly. So the College of Engineering prides itself on three big things. The first one is first day readiness. So Cal Poly is confident that by the time their students are at the first day on their job or their internship, they're ready to take on whatever is handed to them because they've been applying what they've been learning for the past 4 years. The second big thing is labs. So as a Cal Poly student, you would have a lot of labs. As a Cal Poly engineer, you would really have a lot of labs, but the labs are super cool and really important to the learn by doing education here. And the third big thing is industry sponsorship. Let's talk a little bit about what each of these mean. So, first day readiness. One of my friends, Jacob, works in our cube satellite lab where he actually gets to make 10 centimeter by 10 centimeter cube satellites and launch them off into space. So Cal Poly Engineering is nationally recognized by a bunch of companies that know that we produce really, really great engineers. So Cal Poly students are specifically sought after by all these companies, and that also means that they give really cool machinery as well as money to our school. But the way that I find this affects me is that all the teachers I've had here at Cal Poly have either worked in industry before or still presently work in industry. You have teachers who've been out in the real world and are able to teach those tangible skills back to you. Plus, it's a really cool opportunity to have that first step of networking with what you might want to do in the world right in your own classroom.
So now I'm sitting outside of the agricultural building on campus because I will be talking about the College of Agriculture, Food and Environmental Science, which is actually the second largest college at Cal Poly. Within the College of Agriculture, there's a lot of really interesting and fun classes that any student can actually take advantage of. Some majors that are included here include Ag Business, which combines the agricultural industry with the business world. There's also a wine and viticulture major where students are able to learn about the wine industry and how exactly wine is made. Being in SLO, we're less than an hour away from Paso Robles, which has a lot of different wineries where students are able to actually intern and work there and really get that exposure to the industry. Now a little bit more into the agricultural majors. While Cal Poly's campus is only about 150 acres, we own over 9,000 acres of land, some of these mountains behind us, as well as a ranch out in Santa Cruz, and a lot of different spots that students are actually able to get out of the classroom and work in these different units that we have. We've got our own equestrian unit, a dairy unit, a horticulture unit, a learning tree, arboretum, a lot of these resources that are used by students within the College of Agriculture. We've got our own equestrian team, a logging team, classes where you go out and go on hikes and observe different animals and different trees and plants that are around you. Cal Poly also hosts a rodeo every year that sells out. We totally dirt out our football field and host a rodeo that'll always end in a little country concert. My friend Jacqueline, who's a nutrition major, had a class entirely where they learned how to make and all about the nutritional facts that goes into different jams. And then she got to take those jams home with her and eat it. That the jams that she actually made, which is crazy.
What?
Let's talk a little bit about the College of Liberal Arts. Within this college, you can study things like journalism, English, history, psychology, music, theater. Anything in that big humanities bubble will be founded within the College of Liberal Arts.
One of my favorite Learn by Doing moments is this directing class that I have to take to graduate with a BA in theater arts. So in this class, rather than just reading a book about, in theory, if you were going to direct a play, this is what you would do. So we have to find a play, we have to file for rights for the play, we then have to cast real people in the play, we have to direct real people in the play, and then, rather than taking a final where you're being quizzed on vocabulary terms and conceptual ideas, this play that you've been working on over the entire quarter is then performed in front of paying community and peer members. The printing press. This is actually where Mustang News, our student newspaper, prints their newspaper. My roommate Amanda is the copy editor, or one of the copy editors for the newspaper. So it's been a really great experience for Amanda, who is an English major. She wants to go into editing and writing, to have this experience, to get some of that real world workplace experience, working with a team, taking what it is that she's learning in the classroom and expanding it outside of the classroom and some of the extracurricular activities. So whether it's in the classroom, whether it is in some of Cal Poly's extracurriculars, or getting involved in internships or volunteer opportunities off campus, there are quite a few different opportunities to really actually do what it is that you want to be doing, which is something that I really love about my education here at Cal Poly, is that I've gotten to do what it is that I want to do, and that's been incredibly invaluable.
San Luis Obispo is right in the heart and center of the Central Coast. We're about 3 hours from the Bay Area and 3 hours from LA. The town is pretty much set up for the ultimate college experience. One of the big things is the outdoors. In San Luis Obispo, it's about 70 and sunny pretty much year round. So students are always outside, out and about. Something really cool is that Cal Poly's campus is within 10 miles of 10 different beaches. So if you like to surf, swim in the ocean, or just hang out by the sand, it's a great place for you. Something else really fun is that San Luis Obispo is surrounded by mountains. So there's 9 different big sister peaks here in SLO, and a really fun challenge that students like to do is called the Tri-Tip Challenge. And that's when students hike the Cal Poly Peak, Bishop's Peak, the tallest peak, as well as Cerro San Luis Mountain, all 3 in the same day. And then you go and you celebrate with a tri-tip sandwich. So it's like tri-tips the mountain, tri-tip the sandwich. Kind of cute. When you go downtown, you would see that there's not a lot of big buildings, not a lot of big businesses. Everything is really small and local, and there's a big community feel to it, which makes it really cool. One of my favorite things is every single Thursday, there is a farmer's market. So hundreds of vendors line up, they shut down the streets, and they're passing out great local produce, pre-made dinners, and just a bunch of fun community information booths.
All right, here we are in our University Union, which is usually buzzing with student activities. It's sort of the central hub for a lot of different experiences and fun times that students have. This building right behind me is our University Union building, which hosts a variety of different events. It's got 2 floors. On that top floor, we've got our Chumash Auditorium, which different organizations and clubs can rent out that space to host events for the campus. We've also got a whole amount of study space, desks, and lounging areas for students to relax and study as well. And we've got a variety of different offices.
We actually have our Associated Students Incorporated, which is our ASI, our student government, is based here. So they're doing things like funding our recreation center. They're doing things like hosting really cool events. They're doing things like inviting cool artists to perform on campus. Here at Cal Poly, we have over 400 student organizations and growing. All it takes is 7 of your best friends and a faculty advisor and a signed piece of paper, and then you go to ASI's office and start your own club. So all of these different clubs and opportunities to get involved are all here on our campus, which is really cool. In addition to that, we also have a variety of cross-cultural centers that are centered here. The cross-cultural centers are actually a coalition. There's the Multicultural Center, the Gender Equity Center, the Pride Center, the Dream Center. All of those different groups are focused on making sure that students are able to cultivate their social knowledge, as well as find community, find activities, and engage the rest of Cal Poly in some really, really cool, important discourse. There's all these different centers. No matter what kind of background you may find, it's totally possible for you to feel support on Cal Poly's campus.
Going more into that first floor of the UU, we have got our University Union bookstore where you can buy all the Cal Poly swag and gear that you need. And if you're a student here, you can buy and rent your textbooks and technology that you might need for your classes as well. We've also got our Mustang Lanes, which is Cal Poly's and San Luis Obispo's one and only bowling alley. So while you might be bowling on a Friday night with some friends, there could also be a third grader's birthday party right next to you. Tons of fun. In addition, we've got our Craft Center, which is also managed by ASI, where you can sign up to take a variety of different craft classes, such as surfboard shaping, glass blowing, jewelry making, paint nights, all that good stuff in the Craft Center that you can sign up to take. In the UU, we've also got our Starbucks and Yokrae, which leads a little bit into campus dining. We've got 22 different eateries on campus with a brand new 3-story dining facility opening up, hopefully at the beginning of next academic year. And so tons of different eatery options for students on campus. Alrighty, now we are standing in front of the Cal Poly Recreation Center, which a lot of students actually feel is the true heart of campus. As you are a student here at Cal Poly, all rec center fees are rolled into your tuition. As you walk in, you'll see that we have 6 racquetball courts, 6 basketball courts, 3 different weight rooms, 3 different exercise rooms, and an 1/8 mile indoor track, all to your access. As you keep walking through the rec center, you enter what we like to call the Cal Poly Resort, which is where we've got our Olympic-sized lap pool, a leisure pool. We've also got 3 different beach volleyball courts where you can also play spike ball on, barbecue pits, and a ton of different lounge chairs that students will study and tan at the same time. While we're out here by the rec, I do want to talk to you a little bit about sports at Cal Poly. We've got 3 different levels of sports, which include our D1 NCAA athletics. Cal Poly hosts the largest collegiate soccer rivalry in the nation between UC Santa Barbara. Every year we sell out tickets and we hold that record for the number of students that attend a collegiate soccer game. Going into that next level of sports, we've got our club sports. They're a little bit more competitive and will travel a little bit as well. And that final level is our intramural sports, which are a very low commitment way that you can get involved. You can get any of your friends together and form a team and compete in intramural sports. So ultimately, as you go throughout this decision process, I really do hope that you consider Cal Poly because of all these things that it offers.
In the situation that we're in, this is only one perspective, but I also hope that this can help you in deciding where to spend the next 4 years of your life.
There's a unique sense of charm and kindness to the city of SLO and Cal Poly.
Everything really is your own, and every single day you get to wake up and choose what you want your experience to look like. Hope you love Cal Poly just as much as I do.
Best of luck, and bye. See you later. Thank you.